Hey everyone, it's Dr. Detroit here, the doctor is in, and welcome back to an episode of One Day Restorations. However, this is a little bit different compared to our past episodes because we've been flipping cars and stuff like that, you know, putting them back on the road and all that jazz. But now, you can see that we're not in car mechanic sim anymore, or at least for this episode, because we are in House Flipper. That's right, everybody. I decided to rotate in House Flipper. Man, these birds are really killing my ears. I decided to rotate in House Flipper because a lot of people love it. And I figured it would be kind of cool to just come over here and resurrect some homes. So that's what we're going to be doing today. And so this home, as you can see here, this is a home that if you have the pet DLC for this game, it's called Behind the Rails. Which is really cool. As you can see, the front yard looks like a mess, so we're gonna have to work with that. What is this anyway? This looks like it's some doors, but I think we could probably put a garage door here or something. But first things first, we're gonna need to go in and survey the damage and everything, and take a look inside the house and see what we can do to kind of improve it. So. Let's go in first and see what we can find. Okay. Ew. Alright, so there's a bunch of stuff there. Okay. Let's get rid of those. So this looks like this was a bathroom at one point. Hmm. Okay, and then in here, you can obviously tell this was a vet clinic at one time, but I don't know if I want to keep it a vet clinic. Okay, so we have this room here, and then we have another room here, which has these weird cages. That's beautiful. That's not a bad view outside, but I think we could probably eliminate, or at least change the window a bit. Hmm. Let's go over here and get rid of this. Okay, this might have been another, it doesn't look like it's another restroom or anything, but let's see what's going on back here. Oh my goodness. Okay, so this goes to the backyard, doesn't it? Yeah, it does. Hmm. Okay. So this could be a good kitchen area. Then over here, wow. Hmm. So when you're flipping a home or when you're doing something like this, you want to kind of visualize in your head what you want for this particular home. Now, clearly here you can see that it's its own room, and right here is where I could visualize a kitchen, because then it could go out here to the backyard, and then we can have some fun. We'll have to get rid of those in a sec. Alright, so let me go ahead and do this. I'm actually going to take out the trash and get everything off the windows here. So I think this would be a good time for a little time lapse, don't you think? Okay, so we cleaned up the entire place. We basically picked up all the trash and everything like that. And so now, what I think we need to do next is we need to kind of figure out if we're going to knock out any walls. But I have a feeling that we're going to need to knock out a few walls. So after looking around a little bit, I think we are definitely going to knock out some walls. But first things first is that I need to get rid of this, because this doorway is ugly as hell. So let's go ahead and get rid of it. And we're going to go into my little tablet here and see if we can find a better door. Let's see, what would look good? Let's have a look-see here. Ooh! That's a beautiful one. I want something that'll pop a little bit, but also would look good. And I think a cedar door would be absolutely brilliant. And let's see, the framework. Cedar is a very nice color. In fact, that looks really nice. That looks really nice right there. Okay, and then it'll be white, and then the details. Let's go ahead and keep them golden. Okay, so now we're gonna buy it. We're gonna put it right here. Watch this. How cool is that? There we go. Okay, so obviously it looks like a greener texture out here, but I think that's just because of the way that this works. But this will work better once we have a room painted. But for right now, we're going to go ahead and knock out a few walls. The first thing that we are going to do is I think we're going to go ahead and get rid of this little area here, because it doesn't need to be a bathroom per se. Now, if you guys have sensitive speakers or something, you guys might want to lower them a little bit, because I don't know how loud this is going to get. Let's try it. Okay, if it's not too bad for you guys can, be okay with it. But let's go ahead and continue to knock this wall down. So one thing to keep in mind when you're demoing a building or something, hang on one second, let me do this. There we go. Did we get rid of all that? Now there's just a little bit more. There we go. One thing to remember when you are doing demolition inside of a house is that you want to make sure you don't accidentally demo a wall that doesn't need to be demoed by mistake. And that's what I did right here. As you can see, it actually goes into the other room. Yep, right here. However, we'll figure out what we want to do with something like that. Alright, now, this next part here, this next area, I'm thinking about the possibility, let's see, so if you were to enter through here, and if the living room is set way back here, then what exactly is this area? Oh! I know what to do. We'll put a guest bedroom here, and then there'll be a guest bathroom back here. Yeah. Okay, that'll work. That'll absolutely work. However, let me do this. I think I kind of want to move the door area right to about here, because I don't think I like the idea of having a door right here, or. Let me see, how big is this room gonna be? This is gonna be a big guest bedroom, that's for damn sure. This is what happens a lot of times when you're playing in House Flipper, is that you try to figure out and visualize what it's gonna look like in your head. And the way I see it is maybe, instead of putting the guest bedroom door, like, right here against this, what if it was right about here, maybe? So I think that'll probably be good. And then there's the window. So if there's a bed right there, and the Let's see. If there's a window right here and the bed right here, then you could just go straight over there. Yeah, let's try it. Let's try it. We're gonna start building some walls here. Now, what I'm thinking of doing is, rather than putting the wall right here, I'm gonna put it right about here. Because what it will do is that it will give us a little extra room. But if you notice that it's not going to be symmetrical, because if I put this wall here, which I'll go ahead and do, if you notice, there won't be as much room over here, but that's okay, because we'll figure it out as we go along. But right now, we got to go ahead and build the rest of this wall. So now that we have the wall set up for the guest bedroom, I think I might need to demolish one of them, mainly because I think I may have screwed this up, because there's like 1, 2, 3, yeah, one of them. Okay, let's go ahead and do this one. Now, if this were a real project in real life, if you build an extra wall and you gotta tear it down, that's gonna cost you a lot of money. But here in House Flipper, I don't have any cheats or anything on that gives us unlimited money, but we do have a pretty good account balance there, so we don't have to worry if we make the mistakes, you know? Because we don't make mistakes, we have happy accidents. So now, I'm gonna go back into the tablet, and let's come back over here, and we need to get some interior doors. So let's see what I have here. I want something that'll look pretty good. Something that would look just fine. I think this one would be pretty good. And this door is going to be white. Yeah, that looks good. Ooh. Okay, let's see. Let's put it right there. Yeah, that looks good. Okay, so that comes up in like that. So if the bed is right here, so that would mean that the bed would have to be right up against here, and it can't go beyond the door. Okay, that'll work. Oh, next up, we need to put these lintel things on. These are going to complete the room, so we will do that. There we go. Perfect. Okay, so now it's pretty much where we want it to be. The bathroom door. I don't think I want a door here. But now in here, so let's see. If the sink is right here, we don't even need this extra bit of piping over here. So now to figure out, exactly where to go from here. Because what I'm going to have to do is I'm going to have to close off this wall or do something a little different. Like maybe this could be another bathroom or something. So maybe we're going to put a wall up again right here. Because then the guest... Okay, this is not going to work. Because I don't want the guest bathroom to be bigger than the master bathroom. Oh yeah, you hear that? There's some, look at that. See for the window? I told you this thing was behind the rails. You can actually see a train going by every now and then. So let's see. Let's split the difference a little bit. Let's split the difference like this. You can also look up on the, little map indicator up there, you can actually see what the floor plan is going to look like. Huh. I wonder why that's glitching. Yeah, this is about what I'm looking for. So, let's see. So the sink can go right here. And then I'm going to say the shower goes maybe right here, and then the toilet can go right here. Yeah, that's not too bad for the guest bathroom. Although I'm wondering if it's a little too long. Like, I'm wondering if I should bring it shorter, but then at the same time, let's go ahead and leave it like this. Let's go ahead and get the plumbing stuff in. I'm starting in on the guest room first, and then we can work our way out towards the rest of the stuff. So let's see, we need a shower. We need shower plumbing, and that'll go right about here. There we go. Go ahead and unscrew that, and unscrew there. Okay, and then the toilet is gonna go right here. So now the toilet can be, let's say, right here. Yeah, there we go. It looks like there's going to be a lot of room, but once we get everything put in, it's going to look a little bit shallow. So now let's go ahead and start working on the guest room in terms of the laying down some carpet. Because what I want to do is I want to get the guest area squared away first, so that way we don't screw it up. So for this, I'm going to go ahead and get some carpet right now. See what we got here. Carpet. Ooh, that's cool. So they actually add in some of the holiday stuff. That's pretty good. Oh, look at that, even a Mexico carpet. And that kind of thing. Ooh, that'd be kind of cool to put in. We're not going to do a green carpet, no. Let's see. What else do we have here in this little area? Let's see. We could do... we could do one of these carpets. Not blue. Beige is what we're going to use for the hallway, probably. So what about something like, how about this gray-beige color? Let's take a look. Let's put that down and see what that looks like. That's not too bad, but I feel like we need to paint the walls first, and then we can decide on the carpet. So now for the walls, this is where we need a little bit of something. We need some paint. So floor and ceiling, coverings, no. We need walls, we need paint. The game also brought in a lot of good paint and everything, so we can do something neat with it. And let's see. A fresh morning. That's kind of got a grayish tone to it, but not too bad. Because I think the thing about guest bedrooms is that you don't really want to make them a specific way. Like you could have like a pink bathroom or something like that. But when you're building something from the ground up, you actually kind of want to you kind of want to make it somewhat neutral, so that way if you got, let's say your aunt is visiting, or maybe you have a good friend of yours in there, you kind of want things to be a little bit neutral. So let's try this color and see what it's like. Let's go ahead and paint this and see what it looks like against here. Ooh. Yeah. So clearly I'm a fan of this color, but the carpet doesn't go with this color. Alright, let me go ahead and continue painting this room, and then I'll decide on the carpet in a sec. Okay, so now we have painted the room. What's actually interesting, though, is that even though this is the same color, take a look at what it looks like over here. And now that I'm starting to look at this, I actually kind of think the carpet does go with this color. I definitely am liking it, and with the white door, it's looking really nice. Next up, we gotta take care of this, because this is just ugly as hell, so let's get rid of that. And now we're gonna need to get a window. Well, a window of opportunity, that's what we're gonna have. Let's see, windows. All right, we need something that'll be, very good. And let's see, what would be a good one? All right, we need something that's not too big, and we need something that's not too bad. Ooh. Yeah, that looks... Ooh. Let's see what that looks like. Okay, so it looks like it's not going to be non-symmetrical, but that's okay. Okay, and here we go. That's not bad. That's actually not too bad. And they open like... Oh, interesting. They open like that. Alright, we're definitely going to need to put some curtains up for it. But now, that's actually looking really nice. Okay, so now that we have that sorted out, let's come over here into the bathroom. Now, the bathroom should be pretty easy. The guest bathroom... One interesting thing about guest bathrooms and stuff is that sometimes they will have, like... bathtubs and showers and things, because maybe it was a different maybe it was something different in the past. So that's what I'm going to do with this bathroom, is that I'm going to give it that very same touch. But when it comes to tiles, or when it comes to epic voice cracks, when it comes to tiles, I'm kind of wondering, I don't know if I want to do beige. The black tiles just don't look right. How about these rectangular white tiles? Let's lay these down and see what they look like. Yeah, I like that. Now, this part right here, I'm gonna need to do something with, or I could probably just leave it right there and be like a cool transition back and forth. Now, to do something in here. Now, I could tile this entire thing, but I'm not going to do that. Instead, I'm probably just going to put tiles over there where the shower is going to be. And it's best to tile before the shower goes in, so that we don't have anything in the way. So I'm going to go ahead and grab some wall tiles. Let's see, walls, wall tiles. There goes another train. And, let's see. Ooh. Graystone cladding. I wonder what that looks like. Let me get a couple of those tiles. And let's start putting the tiles on. Let's see what this looks like. Ooh. Okay, that... This one... Huh. Well, it might work for the shower. I think, let's get the shower in now. And see what it looks like against the shower, or actually against those tiles. So let's see what kind of showers we have. I just want to put in a main shower, like this thing. Let's go ahead and put this in. See what this looks like. There we go. Okay, let's get it right there. Now we assemble. Very easy to assemble these in game, but if you were doing this in real life, obviously it would take a little bit longer. But that is... That! Oh yeah! I like that. I kind of like that. That's really jiving with me. Okay, so now the rest of this, the rest of this could be wall tiles as well, but I don't want it to look too bad for me. So let's come back over here to the wall tiles and see what else we can put up. Something that'll make it look really nice. Well, we could go with these white tiles to give it a nice little area, or we could go pink. Yellow just doesn't look right. Blue-green could be nice. Turquoise, not so much. I mean, turquoise is not bad, but I don't know if I really want to do that. Light blue tiles could work. White tiles, nah. Black tiles are not going to be good. The green ones are just not going to look right. Could also go with more brick. Could also turn into a whole brick area, but I don't think I want to do that. Alright, maybe these bluish tiles would work. Because they do kind of match the guest bedroom. Alright, I'm going to start hanging some tiles here, and then once we're done with that, we'll get the rest of the furniture in for the guest bathroom. We'll change out the window, and then we can move on into the next part of the house. Okay, so now we have the tiles up, and I really like this transition from a fresh morning into this blue, into this bluish bathroom. I think these are going to be okay, but I'm really digging this. And now we need to get rid of this this window of opportunity, and let's get another window in here. In fact, I'm almost willing to just do this again. Because this looks really nice. This absolutely looks really nice. There we go. So once again, same type of window setup as this. I am going to need to put some curtains up, but we will take care of those in a little while. Meanwhile, let's go ahead and get a sink and a toilet in here. Because now we're at the point where we are almost done with this particular room. And let's see. I think we can... could probably use this type of sink, I think. Yeah, pretty nice. Very rustic. I like the gray oak look. The handles could be a black kind of color. The sink, we don't need it to be gold. We could do a white. We can do a white sink. The faucet can also be white as well. There we go. It looks like this one's more of a kitchen sink than anything else, but that's okay. But at least now, small kitchen. This is supposed to be a bathroom. Let's see if adding a toilet will tell it to be a bathroom, because maybe we got the wrong type of sink. Let's go ahead and get a toilet in here. We got a bunch of toilets here, but let's go ahead and get the standard one. There we go. We get to assemble it ourselves, too. There we go. Perfect. Yeah, it's still saying small kitchen, so out this goes. I don't know why it's saying small kitchen when it should be a bathroom. Let's go back into the sink category really quick and get a different type of sink. Needs something that'll look good with a bathroom. And, let's see. Ooh. 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 That. That I think I can deal with. There we go. We can assemble it now. Always make sure to have the water off before you work with any of these pipes or anything. There we go. Get that turned on. Get that turned on. Yeah, that's pretty nice. Now, we will aestheticize this in a little while, but I'm going to say the guest bathroom and guest bedroom is a wrap. Okay, so now, let's see what we can do in here. Okay, this should be where the living room should be. But what about this area? This is an extra room. See, I want to kind of demolish this, but I also know, too, this will be an entrance into the kitchen. Because this is a pretty big house. This is a fairly decent-sized house. This will be where the downstairs, or one of the main bathrooms could be. This could be an extra guest bathroom. And then over here, well, in here could be the master bedroom. So, maybe, let's see. What's on this other side of the wall? So clearly what I could do is move the wall back a bit, and then, yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. So what I'm gonna do is I'm actually going to do this. So I'm gonna put this right up against the window, and I'm gonna use this as kind of my guide to stop. So that way I don't accidentally smash these walls all the way. Yeah, there we go. Okay, and then right here, and then right there, and then right there. Okay, cool. Alright, well, cut to another speed up, because I got some walls I gotta demolish. And you know what, too? These speed ups that I do not only help save a little time in the video, but they're also kind of fun to watch people do things in fast mode, isn't it? Okay, there we go. So now we have that wall knocked out. I'm trying to figure out what this area could be, because maybe this is not going to be the master bedroom, because I look at this a little bit more, and now I'm starting to think this could be an office, to be perfectly honest with you. To be an office right off the side here, and then something back here could be like the guest, could be like the master bedroom or something. Now this would be where a car would go, so I'd have to screw that up a little bit. And then in here, where this is a main bathroom, I may need to change a few things out. So, you know what I think I'm going to do? I'm going to use this. I'm going to use this as a short break, but when I cut the camera back in, hopefully I'll have an idea of what this room and the other room are going to be like. Hey everyone! Alright, so while you guys weren't looking, I had a little brainstorm that I was going to do. So remember how I said this was going to become an office area or something? Now I'm kind of switching it around to make this a kid's bedroom, I think. Because take a look at what I did over here. I basically got rid of the walls here to give it a little more space, but if you look, I have built a wall here, because what I'm thinking is maybe this will become the master bedroom, and the bathroom will go right here in this area. So it'll be sort of like an L shape, but it'll be just fine, because then we will get rid of this window, I think, because I can put it behind over there. I think that'll look really nice. And then over here is going to be the office area. So this will be where the office is, and then this will be where the kids' bedroom will be. So I think that's what I'm going to do. So what I think we will do next is I think we're going to work on the master bedroom and get that squared away. Now, in order for that to happen, I need to map out how big I want the bathroom to be. So let's see. Perhaps from right there, and then right maybe to about here. Because the master bathroom and the master bedroom are usually the bigger rooms when it comes to bedrooms and stuff. So I think I'm going to go ahead and do it like this. And then I'm going to have the entrance come out like this. Yeah, there we go. That looks really cramped. You know, it may even be better to go ahead and, like, let's see, how many? Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4. If I go out here, that gives me that gives them an extra bit, but if I go to there, that gives them about at least two more levels over. So, yeah. The office will be a little bit smaller, but that's okay. That's okay. In fact, I don't want it to be too cramped. So, yeah. I'm going to go ahead and demolish these new walls. Well, part of these new walls, anyway. And I'll go ahead and put up these newer walls. Okay, so now we have another interesting problem, because now that we extended this wall a little bit, there's this gap right here. I think the only way to kind of fix that is to just make, like, almost like a curve. Like, do it like this. Yeah, and then just go like this. That'll work. Gives a little bit of space here, but it also gives some room to put something in. Okay, that! Dudes! Look at this! It actually looks a lot better. Now there's a little bit more room for the master bathroom to do its thing. So, I think we're gonna go ahead and get rid of these walls too. Pretty neat. Okay, now we can start rebuilding the walls again, because now that we have all this beautiful space, let's see. So if a shower can go over there, and then maybe a toilet can go next to it, and then the sink can go right there, then that means that we can put the door facing this way. This big window is going to have to go unless I keep that big window there. So let's see. Let me start building again. Okay, so that'll go to there. And we still got plenty of room for a door, so we'll just go right here. You know, one thing I could do to separate the two rooms is to put a door frame right here. So let's do that. Let's go ahead and get a door frame. Because then that'll help us out. Let's see. This should be pretty good. Okay, let's see how this looks. Well, it does eat a little bit into the window, but that's fine. That's not too bad. It's actually, I think that's going to be just fine, because then if we start building a wall again right here, yeah, I think that's going to work. Because this is going to be one of those, types where there's really not enough space, so we'll just have to go with what we have. Because I don't really want to cut off more space for the office. Okay, that looks good. So let's see, they come in like this. Okay, so here would be the bed. So the bed would actually go this way. Television set could go... Well, that was weird. Television set could go right here. Yeah, it's gonna be a little bit cramped. Yeah, but you know what? That's not bad. I'm kind of digging this. Okay. All right. So now that we have that sorted out, and now that we kind of know what we're doing, I'm gonna get a door for this place, and then what I'm gonna do is I'm actually going to leave this right here, and I'm actually gonna start working on the office and the floor area, because once I get a floor laid down, then I kind of know what direction we're going in with this. Yeah, I think this'll work. Oh, hold on. Little something right there. There we go. Yeah, I think this'll work. So let's rebuild the walls right here. This should be just fine, and then yeah. There's enough room for a washer, dryer, and that kind of stuff. Alright, let's go ahead and build the rest of the walls, and I'm going to put the door in, and then we're going to get this storage room squared away. This is perfect. But what I'm gonna have to do is I'm gonna have to put some lights in here to get this working. But now I can begin to put in the piping for a washer. So let me see. Here we go. Washer plumbing system. That's what I'm looking for. So installing a washer in this game is very easy, actually. Let me just bring over here a mountable washer. Can't really change anything with this, but this thing looks really nice. So now we're just going to put it in place, and now we're just going to assemble it. Just get that. Sort it out. There we go. Took a second there to get that piece. Now we hitch up the hose, screw that in, get that in, put this in, and now put the water hose in, and now it's there. Now you might be thinking to yourself, well, wait a minute, Detroit, you haven't even done the floor or the walls yet. That's true, but in this game we can actually work with this. With furniture on top of it. So now, let's go back over here to the floor tile area, and let's see, I think, you know, I kind of like the idea of putting, like, let me see what these black tiles look like, see what they look like on the ground here with this. Ooh, okay, that just looks more like a portal tile, like a non-portable tile. I don't know if I like that so much. That doesn't really thrill me. Let's see. Now there are these panels too. This black panel. Let's see what this looks like on there. Well, that's a little better. This is only going to be a storage room, so it really doesn't matter what it looks like, but I do want to have it be a little bit cooler and just be kind of neat, because nobody's really going to be looking in here. And I'm thinking that maybe we'll go ahead and put some wallpaper back here. Like, let's see, what kind of wallpaper do we have? I don't want anything that can be too distracting or anything, but nah, let's go ahead and just do wall tiles, see what they look like. Well, there is one idea that I could do. I could put up these marble tiles, and that way it'll actually keep things cooler in here, especially during like the hot summer months. So I think that's what I might do, but I don't know if I want to do marble tiles. Let's see. Let's see what these look like. These kind of look nice. They kind of have like a rust color to them, but let's see what these look like. Ooh. Yeah. I think I dig that. I think I definitely dig that. I'm gonna get a few more of these. Alright, let me go ahead and tile the rest of this, and then after we're done, I think we're gonna start work on probably the kitchen, but I'm not sure what we're gonna start work on next. This is not bad. It kind of makes it look like it's an older style storage room, but I think it kind of looks nice, to be perfectly honest with you. Okay, so the storage room is done for now. Now what we need to do is, I think I need to really address the living room here, because the living room is like the most popular room of the house. And we're gonna need to fix up these walls a little bit, but I'm wondering if I want to keep with the theme of just keeping these walls at Silver Glacier, or give them a completely different style. Because one thing you don't want to do is you don't want to have colors clashing too much. And sometimes it'll look pretty good, sometimes not so much. So we have to kind of figure out a happy medium here. But sometimes you can actually use colors that'll look pretty good, like there's even ice blue, which looks really nice, but there's also another one too. Sky blue even looks pretty nice. But let's see, isn't there something called water abyss? I don't know if I like that. There's also forest mist. Let me see what forest mist looks like. Let's get a small can and sample it a little bit. Let me see what it looks like on this wall. It's always good to basically paint on what I like to call the non-hero side and see what it looks like against the other colors. So let me see what this looks like. That's not too bad, because that kind of gives it a little bit better look, because if you look at this, so you go from a little darker to a little bit brighter, and that might actually work. But what if I was to bring in the water abyss, and let's also go ahead and get ice blue, because I want to really see what these look like, because maybe I want to do something with these. So let's go ahead and put some ice blue here. See what this looks like.
That's not a bad color combo, but I can't see that being used for the entire walls leading up to the kitchen. Let's try this other one. This, I think, is the water abyss. No. So clearly it looks like forest mist is going to be the way to go, because it is going to give us a nice little bit extra there. Yeah. Well, one of these can actually go for the kitchen. In fact, I think I might know what I'm going to do. I'm going to take this little guy. I'm going to take it over here to the kitchen, because this I think we can definitely make into something good with this paint. This other one over here, maybe not. So you know what I'm going to do? Once again, I'm going to speed up the camera and see if I can get some more of this stuff. But the only reason why I speed up the camera is just so that you don't have to sit here watching me paint for a ton of hours, because if I'm not doing a Bob Ross imitation or something, then it's not gonna be right. So let's go ahead and speed up the camera a little bit. That is looking really good. That actually looks really nice. And let's see. The transition between this to here is actually very good. Yeah, so I put up the, I think it's called Forest Mist, and this actually looks really, really good. I like the transition, but now I'm starting to think that probably the white carpet is not going to go good with this, because if you see over there, we got a bunch of different colors that are kind of, like, weird. So I'll have to figure that out. I think I'm going to make this pathway here almost like, oh, I don't know, maybe even some wood planks or something like that. But I'm very happy with the way that this turned out. As you can see, I got rid of the windows to make some new ones. So now what I think we're going to do is I think we're going to go into the kitchen and we're going to start working on this over here, because I really want to get this kitchen taken care of. So let's see, the tiles. Should it be all tiles or... So this is where we get a little bit interesting, because now we're going to be dealing with basically a kitchen. And a kitchen is definitely a lot different than a bathroom. Okay? Because, see all these things? It just looks more like a bathroom than anything else. But we could actually make this so that it looks like what a kitchen should look like. And so, let me see what we got here. Now, I did see those diamond tiles. Those might come in handy. Or, we could also go with this. Let's see what this looks like. Let's go ahead and lay down these tiles. Ooh, that's pretty good. That's actually really good. That could work. But now, let's go over here to the painting area. And let me go ahead and put this color on. This is, I believe, the water abyss? Let's see what this looks like. Let me see what that looks like against the tiles. Ooh. Yeah. I'm really digging that. Do we really need three windows? I think we could probably just go with two of them, maybe. Maybe get rid of the middle one and then just do something with it. Yeah, I think I'm going to get rid of the middle window, because I don't like the fact that there's, like, you know, two different windows right here that are just kind of, like, clashing with each other. So, let me see. I'm going to go ahead and just get these bottom parts painted. Yeah, this is going to look like a really good kitchen once we're done with it. So yeah, this window is going bye-bye. Oh, look at that! It even keeps the paint. That's good. Painting walls, especially when it comes to real life, is not like this where they just magically appear, because here's the problem. You have to really commit to the painting. One thing in particular too is that you also risk, if you run out, you also risk the paint drying a half a shade difference, or sometimes there's a different shade. So you always want to do this whenever you're painting a wall. or anything like that, you want to make sure that you get this taken care of, you know, right then and there. Now, you might be able to risk it a little bit, but if you live in a climate that, you know, is kind of like hot or cold, or, you know, whichever way that you live, then it's going to look like that. It's probably going to look a little bit wonky. So just keep that in the back of your head when you go to paint homes. In fact, I'm going to need an extra can, I think. I need an extra can of this stuff. Let's see, I think it is Water Abyss. Let's make sure. Yep, it is. I always get the big cans because then if I make some mess ups, then I always have an extra can nearby. And let's see, I'm gonna need to get rid of these windows. So let's do that really quick. And let's do just some regular old windows here. Oh, let's go ahead and do these. These look really nice. Ooh, yeah, they look good. Yeah, right there. Oh yeah, look at that. That's gorgeous. That's really gorgeous. Even have a couple of extra windows to kind of help with moving air and stuff. Alright, so we have that. Let's go ahead and get rid of this and put the same type of window here as well. Oh yeah. This is starting to look like a good kitchen, that's for sure. And you know what? It looks so good, too, that I might leave that top part white. Because it kind of just rounds out the window pretty well, doesn't it? Yeah, looks like it does. Thank you. So what you guys just saw me do just now is that I went ahead and I got rid of the old door that was right here. And now we can go ahead and basically paint this up like so. And I can now go ahead and put some of the tiles that we were using on here too. There we go. Oh, look at that. Cool. So it actually created a little patio area, which we'll have to tackle this, not in this video, I don't think, but maybe in the next video, because I'm starting to think this is going to become a two-parter. So, okay, you know what I'm going to do? Here's what we're going to do. Even though this is a one-day restoration type deal, sometimes some restorations take a little bit longer. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to continue painting, and I'm going to do some stuff off camera, and then when we come back in the next video, we will tackle the outside, and I'll show you what I've done. But anyway, that's going to do it for this episode of One Day Restorations. If you guys want to see more of it, make sure you leave a like and a comment. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll continue painting around here. But I'll see you guys in the next video, and don't worry. I'm not going to do too much, so you guys don't miss too much. But anyway, until then, take care.